Welcome to Western Pools Fishery. Now it's approaching into the springtime. Shallow fishing is going to be the number one method which can help you build them big weights or catch loads of fish. Now it's a little bit different to the sort of summertime methods. The water's still a little bit clear, fish are still a bit cagey, so fishing to features is going to be massively important. Now, what I mean by this is reed beds and far bank cover, or like today behind us, we've got a nice big aerator where the fish can feel dead safe underneath, hide, feed nice and comfortably, and help you get more bites. As far as targeting these features, your setup doesn't really differ to anything than your normal shallow fishing. So basically I've set two rigs up, I'm just going to explain them now. So the first rig, what you find, because the water's so clear, the fish are really responsive to the sunlight. Like today, it's really bright, it's nice and warm, we're in a t-shirt, and the fish are going to do the same, they're going to try and get in that sun. So one thing, you might have a little bit of sort of mugging scenario, like you might see a fish in open water or just off where you're fishing. Now this rig is a sort of like a multi rig for that. You can fish it in your feed, but if you see a bigger fish or fish moving around, you can change it up and have a flick at it. So now this rig, both rigs have got 11 jaw slip in, just a nice elastic you can get. We had some big carp today, up to 15 pound. We managed to get it in on this elastic, so you can get anything up from little tiny stockies from like 6 to 8 ounce up to big 15 pound carp. So it's ideal elastics, not too harsh, but it's not too soft where you're going to be bumping and losing fish trying to pull too hard. Now the reason you spoke about like a sort of flicky mugging rig is I want a long piece of line above my float. This because it allows me just to enable to keep my pole away from the fish. I've got my ghost kits on today just so it gives me a little bit more cover from the fish. As you can, as you'll see, the water's so clear today, it just, anything that gives me a little advantage to catch more fish, I just think's just a little massive edge and it helps you catch more. Now, for this sort of fishing, you're gonna be fishing, say, like, if you're looking to flick and mug, you're fishing anything like 12 and 18 inch sort of depth. So I've got these on my top kit markers, on these new XS ones that comes just nice and easy. I can just literally slide up to 12 inch or 18 inch, just marks it and I know I'm fishing bang on with the spot or where I am. Now, for this, I've just got a tiny little Tyson dibber. Just creates minimal noise when going in, takes next to no shot. I've just got three number 11s there, and I'm literally gonna, I can move them around, I can have them a bulk, or I can spread them up and down on my line. And then I've literally got on this one a 2 inch hook length, just so it goes in proportion with the rig. A 3 inch would be fine, but I just like a 2 inch, just so it goes in proportion. And that's a 013 to a size 16 GPM, the banded hook length. Just want a banded hook length, so it just saves, I might be able to net a fish and the bait still be on, I can flick it back in, be nice and efficient, nice and effective. So that's sort of like the flicky muggy rig thing. If the fish come to like 12 or 18 inch deep, we can use this rig as well. But as we've been having today, the fish have been really responsive and feeding. So I've got a traditional sort of like F1 shallow rig. I've got my elastic again, 11 jaw slip. Now, touched on it, sorry, the main line now is 017. Because the fish is getting a little bit better, we're catching a fair few more fish. 017 main line, nice and robust, not gonna let you down. And on this, for this one, it's set about 20 inch deep, literally, just an 4B8 F1 shallow, just set, just takes next to no shot. I think it's three number 11s again. You spread them out down the line. This one, I've just got a 3 inch hook length, just because it goes in proportion with the rig. So they're the rigs, dead simple, but dead effective when fishing up to these cover this time of year. Right, so that's enough waffling now. We've got all the rigs set up. You've seen why we've got them and how we go about it. Now, just quickly, bait couldn't be any simpler. Just got some 4mm fishery feed pellets, and that's all I've got on my side tray. Just simply our hook, there's like two styles of pellets, just as an indicator in there, so I can hook two different types of pellets. And I've literally got little catapult, and I'm literally just firing. I'll just do it before I go out to the aerator, just firing a few pellets out. Now, first of all, I'm just gonna start on my rig that's about, say about 20, 22 inch deep, just in the middle of them markers, and just gonna see if there's any feeding fish out there. Now, you may think, well, why have you chose to use pellets over sort of like casters and maggots? Well, when I'm fishing to features, I like to have the fish feeding at a set depth. You'll see when we're fishing, we're not gonna be slapping our rig all the time. Basically because you're fishing to where the fish are, so you don't need to make loads and loads of noise. You don't need to like waste time doing stuff like that. Now, in the open water and stuff and different styles of fishing, that's perfect. But with this, I can just flick it in and fishing where the fish are. I can keep it nice and still, and I just want to get it at a set depth, so that's why I've chose to use pellets. Now, see what I mean? Now, flick it in. Just make sure you're conscious of where your shot's going. And with features, because we like to say we're fishing to set fish and I'm trying to set it at set depth, I'll lift and drop quite a bit. So there, on straight away. Now, the reason why I lift and drop is because the fish are naturally going to want to be around this area. It's a nice big paddle. There's even like there's a nice big corner around to our right as well. So the fish are naturally going to want to be here, and we've been catching all sorts today, from like little stocky fish like this. It's actually quite a nice one, to be honest. It's not really a stocky, but nice fish. Now this venue's had an introduction of like burst of these fish stocked over the winter, and it's made it fantastic sport. We're getting loads of bites. Put him back, which just makes it fantastic fishing, but you can get all sorts of, like I say, we've had big carp up to 15 pound. We've had loads of little fish like that, like small stockies and some bigger ones, but it's all about keeping that routine. So get that rig flicked in. Watch that rig falling through the water. If you get a sign, just give it a little lift and drop. And remember, any signs or indications or movement, you feel there's any fish above your float, you can literally come back, just move it that down, that's a tiny bit in, 2 inch difference. And cause you like hold it there and just drop it. Just creates a fast drop. Just like sort of antagonizes the fish into taking it, like that one there. Just try and move it, trying to do around the aerator. See there, that may only be a smaller style F1, but if I had to say like a 7-jaw slip on, which has been perfect over the winter months, that fish could have easily just ragged me around that stanchion. Didn't fight at the end there, give all the fight at the start. That fish could have easily had me around the stanchion, and you're just setting up new rigs and just a hassle. No one wants to do that. I just want a nice day fishing. What I'm going to do is just add a few liners. So I'm just literally going to move my rig down, say like to 20 inch now, instead of 22. Go out, make sure we're nice and on the money. One little slap. Watch that rig turning over. Any movement, just a little lift. See there, just that little lift and drop again. So you're fishing where the fish are like, feel safe. You don't need to be slapping your rig all the time. So we say we're getting loads and loads of bites. These nice little newly stocked fish, which hopefully in years to come, they'd be nice big 3 and 4 pounders, but. So like you see, we're catching loads of fish, and it's really, really nice fishing, but I am always scanning all the time, just the water, just to see any dark shadows, shapes of bigger fish around the peg, because then bigger carp can be a massive bonus in your matches, or even just a nice nice thing to catch in your pleasure session. You can literally just keep an eye out all the time. If any bigger fish moving around. See, there's one coming at the back there. So what we're gonna do now, I'm just gonna try and quickly pop that fish back. Literally just gonna swap rigs quickly. Just because, like, we might have get a chance to catch a bigger fish. And this is the beauty of it. Now that fish has come right at the back of our rig there. This is the exciting thing about this sort of method. You can see a big carp there. Just flick it out and don't smack it so hard, just literally flick it. It's gone right in the back. Now the beauty of this is, say if I don't get a bite there now, I can literally just come back to my mark, flip my rigging where I'm fishing, and he's come back again. Gone past. Ooh, missed that one. But that's the beauty, you can try and chase these bigger fish about if they're there, but also you can not wasting any time, just being nice and efficient. You can slap your rig over. See there, we're not wasting any time, we're still looking. We've still caught one. But there's a nice, another nice stocky. Nearly big F1 then, nearly a pound, pound and a bit. Don't mind catching them, but what you'll find, you'll have sort of like spells now where you have certain types of gang coming through your peg. I can see actually, bigger ball there. See that one's straight, is that stocky? I think it is, but see straight away, that's not where I'm fishing and I'm feeding. So if that starts to happen, don't get waylaid with it. Still keep your line primed up. Keep it nice and primed, and you still catch your fish. Now, these are like little bonus fish if you sort of think about it. You've caught them off your, not where you're fishing. Nice F1, this one. A little bit bigger than the last one. Normally, you do find that this sort of like flick rig, sort of mugging way of catching them, they do catch a bit bigger fish, but see, it's ideal when you're fishing too. Yeah, it's a nice F1. A bigger one. But it's ideal when you're fishing to features, just to have this style rig, just flick around. You can flick it fish. Just make sure your shotting's all in the right place. I can't actually, I think there's one. Is there one there? Like I say, if you think you can't see anything, just go to your mark. Flip your rig in. One straight away there. Oh, come off that one. Set your pellets on. So if you get this fish at this feeding at this certain depth, just flick it in. And just catch it nice and steady. But always on the lookout for any bigger fish. Oh, come flying across the surface, that one. These little new addition, little ghost style ones. So you can handle anything, you catch fish of like that sort of size, up to big crafty F1s, which are probably hiding somewhere. Say like, I can actually see one dead close to me now. So what I'm gonna do, just drop and have a little go from that way. Might spook off. Just have a little. Spooked off that one. Just gotta keep moving around. Keep, if you don't get any, just don't straight back out. So them fish are naturally gonna wanna be around that spinner. Nice and bright today, and that's a nice bit of cover for him. Nice bit of shade. I'll actually pull the elastic out of that one. And see. Really get them going in this like springtime now. That's a bigger one. A bit crazier than that. So that's a little bit bigger one of the ghosty version. Nice big hump on his back there. It'll be a big F1 when he's a bit older. So there you go, you can see how frantic fishing to features such as aerators, big reed beds, even like little nooks and crannies in between bridges and stuff can be in the springtime. Just a nice simple approach, a few different rigs, get your feeding right and get your bait right, you can catch loads of fish. Now, like I said, just keep an eye out for any muggers coming through. Some days you won't see any at all, literally because if sun might not be out, it might be a dull overcast day. But days like today, it's really important just to keep your eyes on the water, keep scanning across as you're fishing, so you can pick out them bigger and better bonus fish at that time.